Hello everyone and welcome to this video, and I'd say I'm going to be doing something which I've kind of been meaning to do for like a little while now on my channel, but yeah, it's something what I've been kind of thinking over, and yeah, I'm going to be doing a album ranking of Paul Heaton. So basically I'm going to be ranking all 20 albums which he's made, so including Housemartins albums, Beautiful South, his solo work and collaborations with Jackie Abbott. So as I said, there's 20 albums in this list. I've not got them all on vinyl. Some of them are not available, unfortunately. And yeah, I mean, Paul Heaton, he is one of my favourite artists now. I think he's a fantastic songwriter, great, great singer. His lyrics are like top notch, really. So yeah, like if you're not familiar with him, like definitely check out like the first couple of albums, like towards like the top, like off the list. But like as is usual, like I will be going from least favourite to my favourite. So yeah, we'll just get started with my choice at number 20. Then make them think the other works for the man. Which I don't actually have a copy of this, it's the only one I don't own. It's the 8th, it's what it's called. And it's more of a kind of musical kind of soundtrack thing, because Heaton isn't actually on it very much. I think he maybe sings on 2 tracks in total, because there's a lot of like guest performers on it. It's basically, it was something he done for, I think, the Manchester International Festival in, I think, about 2011, 2012 sort of time. And it's kind of about, it's sort of based on like the 7 Deadly Sins and that. So it is this kind of sort of grand sort of concept album, and he's got all these different people on it. It's got a more of a kind of hip-hop sort of urban kind of flavour to it, so it's very different like Paul Heaton. It's almost unrecognisable like as him, and that's for me why it is like my like last place, because it sounds nothing like him. He's not really on it too much, and yeah, it's just not an album which I really care too much about. So yeah, the 8th would come in at number 20. Cause the power you're supplying. Okay, now number 19 is going to this one, which is the Beautiful South's Gold Diggers, Head Nodders and Folk Songs. So this is a covers album which they made in the year 2004. And this is okay, it's not terrible, but it just suffers from the fact that it is, yes, it's all covers, so like they didn't write like any like off like the tracks of the year. I think aside from one, actually, I think there's one original composition, but there is a weird track listing. I mean, there's stuff like You're the One That I Want, like the song from Greece, and there's like Living Thing, The Zombies, This Shall Be Our Year, and then a few other ones like Don't Fear the Reaper, and like even Blitzkrieg Bop, like the Ramones song there, like they tackle. But yeah, it's just not a record, again, which I go back to personally too much. Again, Heaton isn't too much on here. There's more Dave Hemingway and the female vocalist like at the time, Alison Wheeler's sort of album, and yeah, for me certainly sits at the bottom, like off like the pack, like as far as Beautiful South albums go. Still not quite a song. The strange model fiber of the... Next up is one of his solo records. So, you know, this is Acid Country, comes in number 18. And yeah, for me, I maybe need to give this one a bit more of a time to grow, but it is very Americana, very sort of country kind of flavour to it, like as like the title sort of suggests. And yeah, I mean, there's some decent tracks on here. It's not a bad album, like by any means, but it's just not one which I particularly go back to too often. This one was released in 2010, and yeah, like it's never been like issued like on vinyl at all. Real shame, because I would definitely buy it, but yeah, like just have to settle for the CDs now. So yeah, that's Acid Country, comes in at number 18. Convertible, stay garage brown, save after sun. Next one now, number 17, I'm going for the last Beautiful South album from 2006. It is Superby. Now we're getting slightly stronger albums now. There's certainly some tracks on here which I do really enjoy. Things like, I mean, Manchester, like, is one of his all-time great songs. There's stuff like There, this song is really good. The Cat Loves the Mouse is very good. Meanwhile, I've always really liked. But yeah, there are just some other like slightly like subpar songs. And like again, plus like I'm not the biggest fan like of like Alison Wheeler's voice either. Like I don't think she was anywhere near as good like in in like the band, I guess Jackie Abbott was, or Brian O'Connor before her. And yeah, it is just a like average album. I say it's slightly stronger than average, like in terms of all albums ever made, but for like Heaton albums, it's certainly towards like the lower end, like off like the list there. So yeah, number 17 would be for Superby. Well, it can take many years to forge your
friendship, it can take a lifetime to get close. Okay, now sticking with the latter half of the Beautiful South, my next choice is number 16. It is Painting It Red. This one came out in the year 2000, I believe. And this is a double album. It's, I think I'm right in saying, the longest record Heaton's ever made. So there's 20 tracks on here, double vinyl, and I think it just suffers because it is too long. There are some great tracks on here. I mean, like Closer Than Most, I like Just Check In, Till You Can't Tuck It In is really good. You Can Call Me Leisure's fantastic as well. But there's just, like I said, a lot of tracks on here, and a lot of them are quite forgettable, like I would say. So yeah, again, not a bad album, but just one which I think suffers a little bit because of its length. Just when you think she's got all that you got, she got the... Next one now, number 15, is the first album by Paul Heaton and Jackie Abbott. So they got back together, I think, 2014, and they've made four albums since. This was the third one, came out in, I think, 2017, it says, like on the back of Crooked Calypso. And yeah, this for me is, my least favourite of like their collaboration albums. I think just because it's quite an inconsistent record. You've got some great tracks, some tracks that stand up as among some of the best songs he's ever wrote, especially She's Got the Garden. Fantastic song, and there's other great stuff like People Like Us and I Got a Praise. Mostly the first side. There's just a lot of, on the second side, filler songs, like stuff like The Lord Is a White Corn and Silences and The Fat Man. Songs which I just don't like, to be frankly honest with you. Don't really do too much for me. Crooked Calypso comes in at number 15 because it is quite an inconsistent, quite a patchy album. But at the same time, it does contain some absolute classics. That's where this one would go. So if your hand over feels like the dark bar, what's the question? Next one now, number 14, another Latter Day Beautiful South album. It is Gaze, which came out in 2003. And this one, I think, isn't a bad album. Again, it's maybe a little bit like on like the long-ish side. There's 12 tracks in total here. So, I mean, it's not very long, but again, it's just like a lot of like these like latter albums that which I'm showing like in this list. Some of the tracks are called a little bit forgettable, but then there are some great tracks. Things like Just a Few Things That I Ain't is a really fantastic, really witty song there. Life Versus the Lifeless, I really like. Let Go With the Flow should have been a bigger hit single like that it was. It is not a bad album here. So yeah, Gaze would be my number 14 choice. Promises turn to dust. Wedding by... Next one now at number 13 is probably the first shocker like on this list, because I think probably anyone else making this video would at least put this album in the top 10. But for me, yeah, it stalls at number 13. It is Choke. So yeah, the Beautiful South's second album, released arguably at the peak, off their success, because this has their only number one on it, A Little Time. You've also got other singles like My Book and Let Love Speak Up Itself. I think this is a good album. It's just, again, it's in this one is maybe the opposite of like Painting It Red. It's a bit short, this one. Like, there's not enough good material, and certainly by the end of the album, you've got some real filler tracks, things like I Hate You But You're Interesting, The Rising of Grafton Street, and Lips as well, just isn't really like anything too special. But like, at the same time, as I said, it has got A Little Time on it. It's got other favourites such as Should Have Kept My Eyes Shut, really like that one, Tonight I Fancy Myself, and I Think the Answer's Yes. So all in all, a good album here. But for me personally, would come in at number 13. Well, let's drive over cliff. Next one now, number 12. Again, maybe one which people think I've maybe put a little bit too high, but I just like this album though. I think it has got a real rocking flavour to it. It is Cross-Eyed Rambler. So this was his first, his second solo album came out in 2008, so just after the Beautiful South split up. And this one really rocks. Like, there's tracks like I Do. It's just like the guitar sound on it, fantastic. Like Little Red Rooster's really great, God Bless Texas. And then that closing track, Everything is again another one of his all-time greatest songs for me. A really fantastic album, really underrated record, this one here, 2008's Cross-Eyed Rambler.
The whole place is pickled. The people are pickles for sure. And no.
Okay, now just missing out on the top 10, another one. Probably one of the more controversial choices on the list, because I think a lot of people would put this maybe even as like their number one Heaton album. But for me, number 11 is where it goes. It's Blue Is the Colour. So again, one of the Beautiful Sound's biggest albums here. But for me, it kind of suffers a little bit. Like, there's a couple of tracks which I'm not massive on. Things like Liar's Bar, I've never really cared for that song. Things like Foundations, that's okay. It's more a Dave Hemingway, that song. Artificial Flowers, I just don't really like that one either. So there are a couple of tracks on here which I just don't like. And then it probably also doesn't help that like a lot of the songs on here don't actually have Heaton singing on them. Like the two big singles, Don't Marry Her and Rotterdam, both were real showcases like for Jackie Abbott. And they're both great songs, but there's just not enough like off like the man like who made the Beautiful South like what they were like on here, like for me. But like when he is on here, it is great. Things like Blackbird, On the Wire, and Have Fun is fantastic. And then the closing track, Alone, is really great as well. So all in all, another very good album here, like just for me, comes in at number 11. I just think he's made like 10 stronger albums.
Let's swap with the car.
Okay, now we're into the top 10. Kicking that off, we have the first Paul and Jackie album from 2014. It is What Have We Become. Now, this one has been a real grower of an album for me. It's one which I really didn't really listen to too much before I got the vinyl some point last year. I've just been really getting into like this album. I think it's consistently great throughout, like from the starting track, Moulding Off a Fool, through to stuff like Some Dancing to Do. One Man's England is a great track. What Have We Become is another favourite of mine. And then like the second side is also really good. Stuff like The Right in Me, like has a kind of like rocking sort of flavour to it. And When It Was Ours is really great, and Stupid Tears too. So again, another very strong, very solid album here. From 2014, this one is What Have We Become.
And you, the stream so much.
Okay, now number 9. Again, this is probably one which some people might think I put a bit too high, because it's an album which often gets ignored or like trashed a little bit. But I really, really like it. It is Fat Chance here. So this one had quite an interesting history. It originally didn't come out like as a Paul Heaton album. It came out under the alias of, I think it was Biscuit Boy, aka Cracker Man, and it didn't sell one bit. So I think the following year it was reissued with this cover, like as a Paul Heaton album, and again, I think it was pretty much ignored. So this was released 2001, so just after Painting It Red, kind of in like that sort of like the latter years, like off like the Beautiful South, like where like the quality was kind of going down a bit. But this for me, I think is much stronger than any of those latter day Beautiful South albums. I just think like it's got a lot of fantastic tracks. Things like 10 Lessons in Love is really great, kind of very sort of funky flavour to that one. I really like Mitch as well. The Perfect Couple, with all the kind of references to different pop songs, is genius. And then there's a fantastic song, again one of his all-time classics, Poems, is on this album too. A real favourite of mine, a real underrated gem, like in like the Paul Heaton back catalogue there. So Fat Chance would come in at number 9 for me. Okay, and now at number 8, we've got his most recent album, what he's done, which is Paul Heaton, Jackie Abbott's Manchester Calling from last year, 2020. This is a fantastic record. It's on the slightly longer side, because there's 16 tracks in total here, spread across two records. But it is really good. It's really consistent. So songs like The Only Exercise I Get Is You, You and Me Were Meant to Be Together is fantastic. So Happy, A Great Day Is Hard to Find. Yeah, just a lot of fantastic tracks. So Manchester Calling would come in at number 8.
Just like that murder in 73.
Okay, now number 7, I've got the first Beautiful South album, so welcome to the Beautiful South here, 1989. This is sort of one I recently reviewed, and I think, again, my opinion like hasn't really changed. I think this is a fantastic debut record for them. It's got some of their all-time classic songs, Only a Song for Whoever, I'll Sail the Ship Alone, From Under the Covers, You Keep It All In, Woman in the Wall, some fantastic stuff. Again, it just for me tails off a little bit towards the end. Those last couple of songs like Oh Blackpool and Love Is don't really do too much for me, but it's still a great record though. Like more than made up for the fact, like those three like awesome singles. So yeah, Welcome to the Beautiful South comes in at number 7.
We love our love, different sizes.
Next one up, number 6, it is 1989's album Quench here. So, another one from the kind of, like I would say, the height, like offline, the Beautiful South success. This one has that singles Perfect 10, which was, again, one of their biggest hits. Dom and The Table is, again, another favourite of mine. And I think some great album tracks, stuff like Big Coin and The Slide, Window Shopping for Blinds. And I think this is stronger than, say, things like Blues the Colour and Welcome to the Beautiful South, because it's consistent across its whole length. Maybe like the only track I'm not massive on is I May Be Ugly, which is a bit of a kind of rehash like off like Liar's Bar. But aside from that, like every other song is really great on this. So yeah, Quench 1998 in fact, this one came out.
Old brown bear and honeybee, pass me by, wink at me.
Okay, now at number 5, again, possibly one which you might be surprised at how high I put this, because it's a more recent record, but it's one of my favourites. It is Wisdom, Laughter and Lines, Paul Heaton, Jackie Abba, from 2015 here. And again, I just think the reason why this one is so good is because it is so consistent, and it's so consistently great. So not only that, the singles like The Austerity of Love and I Don't See Them, but you've got some great album tracks such as Sundial, In the Shade, a real sort of showcase like of Jackie Abbott's voice there. Lonesome and Sad Millionaire's just a really fun, really witty track. The Horse and Groom is just such a rocking song. I love the guitar sound on that. When Love for a Woman Stops is a lovely ballad. Wives 1, 2, and 3. So a lot of great tracks on here. Again, one which if like you're kind of aware of the Beautiful South and kind of the Housemartins, but haven't really delved into like his kind of solo work, like sort of post Beautiful South, I would definitely go to this one first. Like you won't be disappointed.
I am mad from Scandinavia.
Okay, now we have number 4, which is going to the first Housemartins album on this list. It's their second album, The People Who Grinned Themselves to Death. This one, amazing record here. I think it's maybe has got a couple of fillery songs, things like We're Not Going Back, is kind of Housemartins by Numbers, and Pirate Aggro as well is kind of just a kind of rehash of like Reverend's Revenge. But aside from those, this is great, and it kind of shows them sort of flexing their muscles a little bit, kind of like expanding like on like the sounds like off like first album. So things like The Light Is Always Green like has much more piano on it. Build as well is much more kind of soulful feel. But then there's other great stuff like Bow Down, which has a kind of like the trumpets on it. And then the singles as well, Five Get Overexcited, Me and the Farmer. So a lot of fantastic material like on here. A real classic album here from 1987.
I want my love, my joy, my left, my smile, my...
Next one up now at number 3 is another Beautiful South album. It's this one from 1994, and it is Meow here. So this one I think is a really great record. It's a lot darker feel than most of his other work. I think he was possibly going through quite a few personal troubles like around this time. I think he was around this time, I think, quite addicted to the alcohol, and I think he had personal relationship problems as well. And that kind of all comes through on these songs. It's a much sort of darker, much more kind of somber album, but I think he's all the better for it. I think tracks like Hold On To What, and Prettiest Eyes and like Hold Me Close on Underground are all really fantastic. And I think in many ways this can also be seen, almost be seen like as the first sort of solo album which she'd done, because there's very little like off like the other Beautiful Sound vocalists singing like on the air, like yeah, you've got Jackie on, like everybody's talking, but aside from that, I think pretty much every other song Heaton takes the lead vocal on. I just think it is a really fantastic record. One I do often go back to. So yeah, Meow comes in at number 3.
What a good place to be. Don't believe it. Just speak a different language and it's never...
Okay, now it's top 2 time. So yeah, number 2, the one I've chosen is the Housemartins' first one, London Mill Hole 4. So this was, yeah, it was a tricky choice between like these two here. Like this one could have taken it, but like yeah, number 2 is what I would give it. This was where it all began, really. And they just arrived absolutely fully formed. Heaton's ability to write just amazing lyrics was like being displayed on here, like in full. Plus he was at like maybe like his vocal peak, like on here, like some would say. I mean, certainly tracks like Flag Day and like Get Up Off Our Knees, like his performances on those, like it's hard to argue like with like that. And then like yeah, there's other great stuff like Sheep and Over There, Think For A Minute. There's maybe the only criticism like of this album, what I could maybe give it, is some of the songs do sound similar, certainly in terms of like the guitar sounds and the kind of chord structures used. There's a very sort of like, certainly like the Housemartins, like they had their niche like on this album, like they had their sound, but they do it so well that I kind of like, I don't mind. And certainly like the lyrics like off like each track like is like so different that like it almost like doesn't really matter that like maybe some of the tracks have got a sort of similar feel to them. Still a amazing record though. An all-time classic 80s album here, London Mill Hole 4.
Said we'd be close, said we'd went perfect.
But yeah, now my number one. So I've gone for 0898 Beautiful South here. So this one, 1993, I want to say this one came out. Another amazing album here. I think the songs on here, like certainly the singles, are among some of the best he's done. Things like Old Red Eyes Is Back and We Are Each Other. But then there's some great album tracks as well. Brian O'Connigan's Leaves on the Rocking Chair is one of my favourite songs, like what she sang on. We'll Deal With You Later, just as, again, really great production. I think they had a different producer on this album to the first two. I mean, don't quote me on that, but this one produced by John Kelly, and I think maybe Welcome was done by someone else. The kind of musical textures on here are slightly different, like slightly sort of more sort of dark and more sort of menacing. Things like Here It Is Again and You Play Glockenspiel, I'll play drums. They've just got a sort of like something special about the actual productions like off like the songs. But then I said again, a lot of other favourites like I'm Your Number One Fan and When I'm 84. So a lot of fantastic tracks, and for me, yeah, would be my number one Paul Heaton album. So yeah, that is me going through, yes, my top 20 Paul Heaton albums. So I hope you have enjoyed the video. You're like a fan of his, like I would be interested to know what your sort of like ranking is, like what some of your favourite albums are. I will see you all next time for the next video. Goodbye.
We are each other.